So after seeing the machine learning algorithms, we have clustering algorithms. The clustering is a concept of unsupervised learning in which the objects of similar kind belongs to one cluster. As we see that all these yellow rectangles belong to one cluster. Similarly, the blue rectangles and the red rectangles. So these are the supervised machine learning algorithms, that is K-means clustering, topic models and neural networks. We will not be using these algorithms, but we use supervised machine learning algorithms. So they are Navier-Bayes K-nearest neighbor algorithm and support vector machines, which is also called as SVM. These are the machine learning algorithms which are used in order to classify the email as a spam or a ham. So coming to the data set, we have UCI spam data set, which is very large, so that the algorithms can work easily and classify the email as spam or ham. So we have total of 4600 odd instances, and each instance consists of 57 attributes. There can be continuous attributes or non-continuous attributes. Some of the values can be missing also. So with this, we run the algorithms on top of the data and classify ham as spam. So coming to the first algorithm, Navier-Bayes algorithm. It is based on the conditional probability in the mathematics. So conditional probability is probability of occurrence of an event given that another event has already occurred. So we divide the data into sample data into training set and testing set, and run the algorithms on with different types of sizes. So we have conditional probability given by this formula. Probability of A given B is given by probability of B by A into probability of A into probability of B. So probability of A and B are computed without correlation with each other. I mean, they are not related to each other and independently calculated. So probability of A given B is defined as a probability of occurrence of A given that B has already occurred. Probability of B given A is given B probability such that probability of the event A has already occurred. So we use the same Bayes theorem for our project. So the equation which is discussed earlier modifies into this. So here I'll explain about the equation. So probability of H defines the given male is a non-spam male or a ham male. Probability of S denotes the given male is a spam. Probability of S by W is given as a given male is spam based on a given word. Probability of W by S is given as the word exists in a spam male probability. And probability of W by H is given as the word exists in a non-spam male or a ham male. So based on this equation, the Navier-Bayes classifier classifies the event as a spam or a ham. So we run this algorithm. We have different training set sizes, that is 50%, 30% and 10% out of 4600 odd instances. So we calculate the accuracy and the time taken to execute each time. So we observe that 50% training set consists of 86% accuracy. And as the training set size decreases, the time to execution also increases. So they are inversely proportional. So this is a sample output which I got. Let me show the code. So in this, I have taken the split ratio of the training set and testing set as 0.67, and I have run the algorithm. The output we get like this. So this is the algorithm which I got. Accuracy and the time of execution. So back to our PPT. So next algorithm is K nearest neighbors algorithm. In this it is also kind of supervised machine learning algorithm in which it is used for classification as well as clustering, but generally we use for classification purposes, and especially in our project we use for classification. It takes K as an input which is greater than 0. It significance of how many neighbors we have to find, and the output is based on classification. It classifies whether an object belongs to particular class based on the nearest neighbors. We can illustrate by an example. Let us consider this star. We have to classify whether it belongs to a circles or rectangles. Here we have take initially k equal to 3, which is given by this input. So we observe that this circle consists of a star surrounded by all the ovals or stars, circles. So we can classify that a star belongs to a circle rather than rectangles or squares. So we have more votes for the circles or ovals than the squares. So we classify that star belongs to a class called the circles. We can also illustrate with k means k nearest neighbors with another example. Let us consider a circle. We need to classify whether it belongs to a blue squares or red triangles. So first we take the k value as 3 as an input. So in this circle is surrounded by more triangles. So we classify that circle belongs to a triangle class. So k is equal to 5. As we see the dotted area, we can say that there are more blue squares surrounded by the circle than the triangles for k is equal to 5. So we can clearly classify that as a circle belongs to a blue square class. So similarly, I have run the k nearest neighbor algorithm multiple times such that the training set I have taken always 50%, but I ran the algorithm by changing the k values each time. So these are the different k values, and I accuracy I got as this 80%, 78% for the k value 3. So time for execution is deeply increasing when the k value is increasing. So we observe the in the form of a graph for time of execution for different k values up to 25. So this is the accuracy graph in which we see that the accuracy decreases as the k value increases. So this is a sample output which I got. Let me show the code and give an example. So in this the same code which is I am using the Python, I using Scikit API for all the thing. So here I am looping with the k value as the in a for loop, and iterating the same algorithm again and again on the same data, which is of 50% training set and 50% of testing set. So next we have support vector machines. It is also a classifier algorithm, which is a supervised machine learning algorithm. So we build the data set as a point in the vector space and construct the plane between the two categories. So the idea is to marginalize is to maximize the margin so that the chance of classification will be more correct on the new data. We have two planes between the two categories. We illustrated by an example. Let us consider two classes, that is classes class A, which consists of black circles, and class B consists of white circles. So we have two planes, hyperplanes, trying to classify them. So hyperplane one can be eliminated because it doesn't classify much of black points and white points. Hyper two plane two is considered but it is not optimum because it is not properly classifying all the black points and the white points. But hyperplane three is separates clearly A and B, and it is optimum. So hyperplane three is chosen in this case. So we run the SVM algorithm on different training sets data and compute the accuracy and time to execution in each time. So we say 10% of data training set, 20%, 30% and 40%. The accuracy values goes on increasing for increasing the training set. So time of execution also increases proportionally with the training set size. So this is the conclusion part. We have run three algorithms total: SVM, Navy Base, and K nearest neighbors algorithms. So this is a total chart displaying all the computation times as well as the accuracies for different k values and different training set sizes. You can say that Navy Base algorithm is the best classifier among all these algorithms in order to classify the email as a spam or ham based on the UCI database. So we have effective time of execution and as well as the accuracy for the Navis based algorithm more. So we can be note it to be noted that even if a data set changes and different algorithm works for different data sets, so we cannot guarantee that the Navis based algorithm may work for different type of data set. So this is a project, and by using machine learning algorithms I classify the email as spam or ham using the UCI data set. Thank you.